Nearly invisible, this virus has transformed and challenged humanity. The severe acute respiratory syndrome, coronavirus 2, or SARS-CoV-2, is the cause of the coronavirus disease 2019, commonly called COVID-19. On March 11, 2020, the World Health Organization declared COVID-19 a pandemic.
What makes a response to SARS-CoV-2 different from seasonal influenzas and past pandemics?
To answer this, we need to look at the epidemiology and pathology of the virus. Scientists define the contagiousness of diseases by the average number of people in a susceptible population who contract the disease from an infected individual. This term is referred to as a basic reproduction number, or R0. Epidemiologists discovered that the R0 of seasonal influenzas is 1.3, H1N1 flu at 1.5, and COVID-19 at 5.7. To compare, in 30 days, the seasonal flu can reach 57 individuals, H1N1 229 individuals, while COVID-19 can exponentially spread to 1,280 individuals. Physical distancing is vital in lowering COVID-19's exponential growth. With a reduction to 50% physical exposure, 102 infections occur in 30 days, and to 25% exposure, only 12. This rapid human-to-human transmission occurs when infected respiratory droplets enter individuals via their eyes and nasal and oral cavities, targeting the alveoli located inside the lungs. As the virus spreads throughout the lungs, pulmonary consolidation occurs, in which pneumonia builds up in the alveoli and lungs, leading to a decline of oxygen intake.
Using balloons to model our lungs, we could observe healthy lungs intaking adequate amounts of air. As pulmonary consolidation occurs, air intake decreases and the diaphragm requires greater force for respiration, leading to hypoxia.
This virus is also zoonotic, meaning it originates from animals. Therefore, unlike the seasonal flu, humans do not have a natural immunity. Without vaccines or herd immunity, older individuals and those with underlying medical conditions are at high risk. They rely heavily on the resources of the healthcare system, such as mechanical ventilation and oxygen therapy. As hospitals are overwhelmed, these dire and limited resources are depleted, leading to increased death rates. With an R0 of 5.7, no vaccines or natural immunity, and a rapid worldwide spread of the virus, the World Health Organization declared COVID-19 a pandemic. We need to continually adhere to COVID-19 protocols to prevent it from spreading like wildfire, wash our hands regularly, avoid touching our faces, and practice physical distancing. Yet, we are not destined to be controlled by SARS-CoV-2. As humanity's combined intelligence is astronomical, scientists are constantly finding COVID-19 breakthroughs. Let's unite together and remain positive. As humanity is stronger together, we will steer down COVID-19.